That's a very good advice. I mean, leading up to this conversation, I got some Twitter DMs explaining your track record, and the number was so big that I'm afraid to say it even. But can you sort of explain your track record and what you can share publicly because it's been quite a journey at least.
So I've been active on the stock market for 15 or 16 years, and I'm super proud of what I've been able to achieve, I think the way to do that is that I did a lot of mistakes the first years, so there I was probably just lucky. I started in a really good period 2005, 2006, when it's never easy, but it was easier then. So I did a lot of really, really bad calls, and I got awarded for them anyways. So I was lucky in terms of timing, but I did a lot of mistakes, and I think that I learned from some of them. And then I think I pretty early on found my strategy, and I was able to stick to it. So I started off by being more active, more of a trader. I could have just a position over one day or 2 days, but really early on, I started to understand for me, swing trading is the thing. So for between year 3 and 10 or so, I had like two or three core positions that I held for maybe 12 to 24 months, and then I have swing positions for 3 to 6 months or 1 to 3 months sometimes. And that's evolved to the strategy I have today, where I only have core holdings that I hold for 12 to 36 months. So I think, I've spent a lot of time reading press releases, company reports, and I stuck to my strategy. So I think that would be the best explanation on how I succeeded fairly well the last couple of years.
I mean, it's the famous, I think it's Mark Cuban quote that concentration builds wealth and diversification protects it. And of course, it's all about finding your own investment style. But just to repeat for the people that really wants to understand your strategy, it's basically finding, I don't know if you would say like five companies today and really dig go hard on them and expect them to have the growth trajectory that you predict.
So starting off, I had like maybe, more active approach, maybe 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 companies in the portfolio at any specific time, but those were changed out a lot. So it's more of a trading strategy the first 2, 3 years. After that, I went on to a more like swing trading strategy, and that's when I boiled it down to, for me, to really know my case. Because it's both knowing the company and knowing the case, your investment case. Those can be two separate things. I can see a wonderful company, but I won't invest in it because I don't see an investment case. And it can also be the other way around, that I see a really good investment case, but it's an okay company. So I chose, or I still choose, a really focused strategy. I have between 5 and 8 holdings today, I would say. And the reasoning behind that is that way I can put a lot of time into every holding. So I visit the companies in their headquarters every year. I speak to the management as much as I can, and I read everything I get my hands on. So for me, that has been the strategy. And I can also take it as far to say that if you are willing to put in the time, if you think this is really, really fun thing to do, to be on the stock market and to put in the time, I believe that a focused strategy is the best risk reward strategy to really high returns. And you have to go into that risk reward equation and be okay with taking that kind of risk. Because of course, you will hit black swans and you will have bad calls, but that's part of the game. That's not the argument against the strategy. That's a part of it, I would say.
I asked a friend to describe you, and he said that there were three words to sum you up. It was consistency, quality, and focus. Do you think that's a fair description on your approach in
investing? That was really nice of him to say. Yeah, yeah, but yeah, I think it's a good way of describing it. So normally I only invest in profitable companies. For some limits the alternatives too much. I do still some investments where they're really on the tipping point and so on. But to keep it easy, only profitable companies. And consistency, yes, I think that's been maybe one of my really strong suits, that I don't anymore get sucked into the hype or the FOMO when a holding that I don't understand really runs. For example, I don't speak about specific companies, but for example, iGaming, I've never understood it. It's too hard for me. I think it's too much regulatory affairs that I will never really understand. So I've never rode that underlying trend, and that's okay. You don't have to do them all. You just have to do the things that you understand and do them good.